That's awesome. Thank you. No, we're not doing horseback. Chicken farm where you can feed them. Thank you. Bless you.
Watch the video with the previous group.
Come in nice and close.
It's Felix.
B1. B2. B3. B4. B5. B6. Aloha.
Hello.
Aloha!
Aloha!
My name is Aloha, one of you guys, the tour guides today. This is Longi. Everybody give Longi a round of applause. Okay. We're going to be guys, tour guides. These safety guys up in the back. Just make sure you guys are safe, following the rules out there. If you guys have problems, you guys drop your belongings on the trail. Just stop, wait them down, just walk it up here. Yeah, you have to come up front. You're setting the pace. So when I speed up, everybody speeds up. I slow down, everybody slows down. I go left, you guys go left. I go off the cliff. Yeah, you guys are stuck with me. Yeah. Now we've got a quick safety video. Is it everybody's first time out to the ranch? Yeah. A lot of ground to cover. We got about 4,000 acres of the ranch. It's about 15 miles of trail in total. We've got 2 stops on the northern side, 1 stop on the southern side. We're going to go over some of the do's and don'ts, operations of the vehicles, that type of thing. Does anybody need Nihongo? Yeah, we're going to be on this side. English okay with the rest of you? Yeah. Just make sure you guys can hear and see. It's only a couple minutes long. And we'll be on.
Thank you.
Kualoa UTV tour. Over the next few minutes, we'll go over the standard operation of our UTV safety rules and regulations. For your protection and protection of your passengers, helmets must be worn at all times inside the vehicle. Seatbelts must be properly secured in the proper buckles before driving. Please make sure that doors are properly secure, pull the handle on the outside of the door, close the door while the handle is still lifted, release the handle, the door should be secure. The UTV has an automatic transmission and it stays in high drive. Please do not move the gear shifter or shift any gears during the tour for any reason. The brake pedal is located on the left side of the floorboard and the accelerator is located on the right. Before driving off, you must release the parking brake. Press the button, pull the handle toward you, and push the handle all the way up, away from you, and release the handle. This will silence the brake alarm and turn off the warning. If your UTV is sputtering or not moving, check to see if your parking brake is completely disengaged, or if your driver's seatbelt is in the proper safety mode. While on tour, try to keep a safe distance of 10 feet or 2 Raptor links between you and the UTV in front of you. Drivers are not allowed to take any photos while driving. Do not stop or slow down to take photos, but this will slow the tour for all guests and limit your experience. We'll have more than enough time to take photos at the full stop. No matter how narrow the road, all roads are two-way traffic. Drive in a single file line. There is no side-by-side driving and no passing.
Oh, your morning drive.
Do not stop to open gaps.
Your morning drive on the phone.
Speed limit for this tour is 50 miles per hour. No zigzagging, fishtailing, or drifting. These rules are in place to ensure safety for our guests at Kualoa Ranch. Not following our rules and regulations or instructions of your guides will result in the loss of your privilege to drive our car. The end result will be your guide taking over your vehicle and driving the rest of the tour.
Which is really, really awkward, right? As long as you guys are being safe, not putting people in harm's way, everything goes really, really smooth. Yeah, if you get a little reckless at any point, if you put people in harm's way, come by, ask us to calm it down. And we don't listen to the warning, we will take over. After that, we leave you in the family safety comes for 6 years of prison. It doesn't happen very often at all. In about a year and 2 months of being here, it hasn't happened at all. So I was trying to say this one, mainly for my drivers, there's actually spacing in between the vehicles. If you guys look behind you, there's gaps in between the vehicles, like about what we're looking for. There's
oh, okay.
A lot of gaps in the vehicle in front of you, we'll pick up a lot of rings. If you're walking the road, the other ones that we don't take oncoming traffic, right? The other 7 vehicles coming at you, stand on at 15 miles. I can get really, really serious really quickly if you guys are speeding up to what you think is the group phase. Second thing, or actually, last two things, vehicles-wise, the gear shifter in the middle, a lot of people used to get into their regular car, they pull down on the gear shifter, you hit the gas after that, you will go backwards, the Hourr is not racing when you reverse. That's probably the leading cause for accidents, so please don't do that. And then drivers, you guys will have 2 seatbelt buckles on the right-hand side, there's 6-seaters, you list 3 in the front, 3 in the back, make sure you're in the one that's closest to you, you don't have a sensor in it, and if you're not in the right one, vehicle will sputter out for around 10 to 12 miles an hour. So those are going like, done, check your seatbelt, fix it if it's the wrong one, catch it. If you guys need some help, just stop your vehicle at any time. A lot of people can help. Any questions? Love it. You guys can head down to the gate. That's all I got.
You are driving?
I'm not driving.
You're driving.
I don't want to drive.
No, I definitely gave you license.
I don't want to drive.
No, no, that's why I have to.
I don't know how to drive this.
No, no, you don't worry. It's all. That's why it's a.
Gonna be
B1.
Yeah.
B1.
You guys
gonna be the one right behind.
Okay. No, 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 you'll be fine, Shaw. You'll be fine.
Don't go. 5, 4, 3.
No, you're fine, Shaw. You're okay.
I don't, you know.
No, this is free. No, we get to switch off, so don't worry. Don't worry. Michelle's taking the lead today, or on the driver. That's why I wanted to disconnect. Michelle is capturing this RV. We are in the second. You're in this group. This is my return gift for her. She's gonna drive in Kualoa Ranch. Almost Jurassic Park.
And you didn't jump.
It cuts off right there. Okay. So just basically follow them, but don't get too close. Just same things you're driving, and then.
Accelerating pedal and brake.
You don't touch that, they do. And this
don't
is,
touch what?
This, they do this one, and then that one is handbrake. demonstrating what Tesla doesn't have. pretty well.
Going down to the ocean is your property land, right? And all of this bought back in the 1860s, you get a whopping $4,000 for it. Right, right, guys, check, they got your helmets at 600 acres in that land division, down to 1,300. And you see that back face of the mountain, 1,100 acres in hockey, purchased for about $5,000. So altogether, we've got a little 4,000 acres for a little over $10,000. Okay, just take your right foot and draw a little circle in the dirt. That's what 10 grand will get you nowadays, right? So now there's such land all out here undeveloped, no big buildings, is awesome in today's time. And the reason it was so cheap, when the missionaries came down, they brought a lot of things. They brought written language, they brought Christianity, they brought measles, they brought smallpox, right? So our population went from 800,000 Hawaiians down to 80,000. We lost 90% of our people. The guy that came along with them, seeing what was happening, wanted to help out. And he saved thousands and thousands of lives in the process. He translated all the medical books into our language. A few people from each island sent them back with Western medicine. I wanted to keep him here in the islands doing things for us. This was also the guy that got back our sovereignty from the British when they had Logan and Cape. So he did quite a bit. And if you guys got offered 4,000 acres, you probably wouldn't leave the islands either, right? Pass it down in your family just like we have. In about 173 years, about 7 generations now. So pretty cool. Okay, but before we get into the movies, I want to talk about some of our biggest movie stars. It's actually these mountains. Yeah, if you guys look over to your left hand side, everybody say Kualoa.
Kualoa.
That's where the ranch gets its name from. In Hawaiian language, that means long back, and we'll probably get into the story as to why it was named that. But this mountain in particular, very, very sacred. After a chief passed away, all the remains were gathered, taken up into the lava tubes, and they're walked in 17 to 20 miles, hidden in secret, right? The secret was kept within the family for like 100 years. So, even to this day, we don't know exactly how much are up there. The entire mountain is off limits. Just, you wouldn't want people to go to your grandma's grave site and start disturbing stuff, right? So same idea. Not even the ranch owners themselves. On this side, everybody say mana mana.
Mana mana.
Okay. Mana mana kind of looks like a hand. If you guys hold up your hand to the mountain like this, okay, put your wrist down and then go, hey. I'm just kidding. No. Mana mana, the coming together of two things to create something more powerful. And a good example of this is your hand. It's not only comprised of physical fingers, but those gaps that separate them, right? And you guys coming out to Hawaii, that's really physical. You guys coming to Kualoa is really physical. Those laughs you guys have, those memories you guys make, those feelings you guys feel, right? Two powers that come together creates a vacation which you guys want to come back on. So that's a little bit on that one. Back of the valley, this one's a little hard. Everybody say, Pu'u o hule hule.
Pu'u
Yeah. Clashing of two tides. So if you guys can imagine this mountain as a giant wave, this mountain as another giant wave, they come together, they clash in the back to form that peak. Have you ever been to the beach? Waves do something just like that. Right? This is how they navigate. So when they're in the deep ocean, they basically understood that all the currents move in one direction until it hits that landmass, right? And when it does, it'll split, come together 300 miles out on the backside, create a hula hula. It's kind of like echolocation. Right? You see collisions of waves everywhere. You know, there's islands all up. Okay, so a little bit about the culture. You guys have seen Jurassic Park, any Jurassic Park fans?
No.
Yeah?
No.
How much of that do you think was filmed on the ranch? Give me a percentage.
Oh, gosh. Not even 50%.
Maybe not even 50%. 10. You got the shirt on. Give me a percentage.
I'm going to say, since I'm a Universal fan, I'd say maybe less than 10%.
Less than 10%? That's a pretty good guess. No?
20%.
Oh. No.
96 seconds, right? If you guys remember the stampede scene,
about
1%. The stampede scene was right over here. The rest of it was up on Kualoa. We had a huge Category 4 hurricane come through, wiped out their entire set. So they came over here to finish up. They also came back for Jurassic World 1 and 2. You guys remember the glass balls, the gyrospheres they rolled around? That scene was right over here in the same spot. A little shout out for the first one. We also got things like 51st Dates, Jumanji, Kong Skull Island. Again, all marked with black signs, kind of like that one over there. The time is yours now. Feel free to roll down the hill. You guys can take a picture with my dad, Rob. If you guys need help, me and Lonnie are here for anything, okay? All right, guys.
Then the full Polynesian siblings were neighboring over Hawaii.
Michelle's back in the passenger seat and I'm going to take over.
Thank you.
out deep into the woods. Did you drive in Catalina? I don't remember.
No.
No? I was like, you're gonna attack that island, all the islands. Thank you. I'll slow down.
Where that came from. But this is the halfway point. We covered like half of it so far. We have halfway to go. We have like a 30 minute drive coming up. So right now is a good time. If you guys didn't switch drivers, that would be a good time. Probably want to put your best driver on this next portion of the road. Yeah, anybody familiar with where we might be? What film set might be here? The dinosaur? Anybody want to guess?
Jurassic Park?
I'm trying to remember which.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah, Finding
Nemo. Jurassic Park Part 2, Fallen Kingdom. This is the scene where the volcano is erupting, they're running out of the bunker.
He runs out.
Lilo and Stitch, yeah, I know.
Yeah, right.
Ciao. Ciao. Oh. Michelle.
Oh, they're blocking the path too. I don't know, we'll find out. Sure.
How did you get off white? Right. 3 days, 3 nights. Pass.
Third one.
Literally, pass. You grab one. You
give it to me. As he's running, you give it to me. That's how they. What
happened? 25 years for them. Another 25 years for the water to fill in the ponds, generations that made it.
Then kills the lizard, turns it into a
small place. Nowadays, it holds about 88,000 pounds of fish. It holds a full 6 foot barracuda, 30, 40 pound walleye, 90 pound trevally, all kind of
fish. Everything see, I have the lizard looking down.
Far about it, they don't have to do anything to catch them. On the right side, there's a deep. A bunch of sticks they purposely live in their own gap. They fish them in, the ridges come inside of this pond.
And at the end of the mountain,
why is it open up that first gate, they swim into the second one, you close that one right behind. Much fish still alive.
Tell you the story, you guys
see them. You do it.
You see it? It's pretty cool. Why Manalo? That's about a 48 inch drive. This pond has the ability to move all the way to that area. Instead of going out to the ocean where you're going to do like 11,000 hammerheads a year for the breeding season. Wait. Not even catching. Just bring all the fish, create a refrigerator in your back. A lot of movies filmed down here. First
thing,
we have the
Pilaf
Cafe.
Yeah,
Adam Sandler. That's cool. They actually took down up. Murder mystery to them. Wedding scene in Bali. The crane scene on top of the pylon.
Oh.
Rewatch it, you'll see that island in the background. If you guys have seen Tears of the Sun, it's an old war movie. They go to Nigeria in that one. Same thing. Welcome to Nigeria. But you guys want to hear a quick story?
Yeah, check.
Oh, let me
anyone know the name of that island?
Like Santa Lisa and Sarah.
Oh, yeah.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. Yeah. Chinaman's hat. So during the Confucian era, everybody was coming up to Chinese, Japanese, Korean, Filipino, Portuguese. And the Chinese were the only ones to hide out from the sun. Like they brought the straw hats on,
hit
their head, but also their shoulders and their back. Why is just like sunburned, right? That's about it. So they seen the resemblance, decided to nickname it that. Hawaiian language is also illegal, or like banned to speak, right? 1896 or 1980s. We nicknamed the lava shell.
Do you remember?
Oh, you guys heard of Sandy Beach, right? Another nickname for the place. In Hawaiian culture, Avava Mug.
Yeah. Okay.
So, in our culture, it's called Mokoli'i. Everybody say Mokoli'i.
Mokoli'i.
Except I've been a little piece of the lizard's tail, right? You guys can imagine just the tip of the tail sticking out. So that's why our fire goddess Pele, she's the goddess of the volcano. When she goes to sleep, she has a dream about Hawaii that she falls in love with. And she's talking about volcano. She sends her little sister over there to fetch him and bring him back. On the sister's journey, she comes into this giant Godzilla-sized lizard. So she can't be over here, right? This is sacred land. She has to go around like everybody else. What she's here for, who she is. That answer, right? So she starts to fight it out with this giant lizard. End of it, lizard sees he's not gonna win, so he tries to run away. She grabs onto the tail and pull him back, rips off, throws it out of the water, and lizard starts climbing. If you guys look over to the right hand side, right above the tree line, you guys see that orange tree. Perseverance. Instead of facing a problem and running away from it, you overcome it. Great, they threw it to you as you're going.
We're right behind him because there's a couple in front.
Everybody grab rocks and throw it at this one. Right here.
two cup holders.
Thank you.
to the Philippines, y'all. Vietnam. Or even worse, Thailand. Turn signal.
I am hurting.
Jeez.
Make sure you guys got all your belongings and join us in the back.
I like the shirt.
I appreciate it, bro.
Bye. Right there. About to take